TMS Aurelius supports lazy loading of associated objects. That means that if you load an object tree, a complex object tree from the database, you have all the objects loaded at once, including the associated objects, or you can tell Aurelius that for it to load, only loads the object when you really need it. For example, when you read the property of the associated object. I'll give a simple example here. This is a mapping of an invoice object. In the invoice, we have some properties like invoice date, and we have an associated object of type tCustomer, which is the customer of the invoice. And we also have a blob field with a blob property with name description, because I'll show you that lazy loading works for blobs as well. Currently, this mapping here is simple and it's using eager loading, so no lazy loading yet in action here. This sample code is very simple. After some setup here that doesn't matter to us, we have this code has three buttons here, one for loading the invoice, another for get the customer name of the customer associated with the invoice, and get the description content. Let's see the button, the implementation of each button. It's very simple. Load invoice, we just load the object invoice with the ID 1, and we show the invoice date here in the edit box. Then we have get customer name. It's as simple as using invoice.customer.name, and we have the description, which is also simple as invoice.description.asUnicodeString. Let's execute the application. The application is also displaying the SQL statements used by Aurelius. So when I click the button load invoice, this is the statement that Aurelius executes in the database. You can see that it's already retrieving the description, which is the blob, and it's doing a left join with the customer table to retrieve customer data. So it's already in a single statement. It gets the invoice data and also customer ID, customer name. So we have all the objects loaded here. All the information, the description and the customer name, including all other properties of customer, is already loaded. So when I click get customer name, you can see that it just displays the customer name John and description, the description of the invoice. So everything was loaded earlier using eager load, as we say, with a single SQL statement. Now let's see how to implement lazy loading. What you have to do is use proxy. The proxy type is a special Aurelius type. So we say that this customer is proxied, but note that we only use it in our private field. Our public property doesn't change, so any business logic using the object still uses the same tCustomer type. We just have to implement a getter and setter here. So in the getter, we use the value property of proxy type and the same way in the setter. That's pretty much what you need to do. Let's execute the application now. And when I click load invoice, you can see that the SQL statement doesn't include the left join. So the statement is simpler, faster in some situations, and there is no customer data associated with it. The only thing that Aurelius includes in the SQL statement is the customer ID. When I click get customer name, then it executes an extra SQL statement to retrieve the information about the customer. So the load object, the loading of the tCustomer object is deferred until I read the customer property here. So only when the code reaches this line of code that the SQL statement is executed. And when I click Get Description, nothing happens because we had already loaded the description here. So we can also include makes the blob to be lazy loaded. The T blob type is already supported, so all we can do here is set a property here, colon prop, saying that this blob should be loaded lazily. And if you execute the application now, we see that the description column is not included in the statement anymore. So again, if the blob is, if you have big blobs in your application, in your database, the SQL statement will be faster here, less data going back and forth with the server. Get customer name will fire a statement for loading the customer data, and get description will also fire another statement just to get the description column from the invoice. That's how lazy loading works. It's the It depends. It's not a solution for everything. It really depends if you in the situation of your application. Sometimes it helps, sometimes it's not useful. To finish, I will show you another example with more complex data, which is connecting to an existing database, Chinook database. It's we have albums and tracks and artists. An album is associated with artist and tracks. Everything is configured to use lazy loading. And we are showing the data set here. So you can see that it executes a lot of SQL statements. One to load the album, another one to load the list of the tracks for that album, another one for loading the artist associated with that album. And if since we have a grid here with five records, it has already executed statements to load artist for all those albums listed here. This is an example of lazy loading useful for loading the tracks, but maybe it's not that useful for loading the artist name because it's not very expensive to load the artist name, and for each record we load, another SQL statement is executed. To give you full flexibility, Aurelius offers you the option to choose for each situation if you want to load associated objects eagerly or lazily. You don't have to change the mapping here, that's the idea. So your mapping stays the same. We just change, we just define how to load when you use the criteria to retrieve objects. This is the code used to populate the data set. Just find all T album objects ordered by some field. And if you do a kind of join here, which is creating an alias for the artist association, we can say that you want to fetch artists in eager mode. So this way, I'm switching from lazy to eager mode without needing to change our mapping. If I execute the application now, we can see that there are much less statements. There is only one to load albums and artists. The left join is included here. And then, which is desired, an extra statement for loading the tracks. What we will have here is just when I switch between the records, we just see that only the statement for tracks are being executed. Note that, side comment, since the objects are in memory, it doesn't execute the statement again for the tracks that it has already retrieved, only for new ones. That's how lazy loading works. I think it's a very useful feature for fine-tuning the performance and the way that objects are being loaded without compromising the business object, the entity that we use. I hope it was useful information. Please don't forget to subscribe to our channel to receive updates of upcoming videos, and thanks for watching.